This is usually like a third shot in. It's hard to get to this green in two because of the difficulty of the tee shot through that narrow chute. And we've got this very undulating green, red flag up front. You can see the humps and swales there as it drops off to the front and then drops off to the back right and slopes left to right. This is a shot from the blue tees on number four. And you can see there's a long forced carry over crap and that bunker. So you really have to have a good commanding drive to get it to that fairway. So not recommended from the blue tees for the newcomer, beginner, even average Joe. You can see how uphill it is from the tee box. My drive cleared the bunker on the right, but went into the right fairway. Not really good distance, and it's going to take a good second shot around that hill as it doglegs uphill to the right. Very thick rough in places on the golf course. You can see it's 1 to 2 balls deep and you can even lose a ball in here. Bad side to be on is on the right. I did not hit a good 5-iron and got a completely blind tee shot, shot to the green rather. You can see you're going to want to stay to the right if you're not going to reach the green like me over there. Very undulating green with those two big bunkers to kill you. You got a false front here with a middle lower tier and then a back upper tier, and you got to be able to reach the upper tier if needed. This pin's in the middle tier. This tee shot on number five, you don't want to kill this. I mean, you can really rip one, but you risk going way out left or straight into the trees right through the fence. I just hit a little 5-iron to the 150 or beyond, and looking for just a short iron in. No hero shot here. Got some pretty nice views up here from the top of number 5. This is at number 6. Beautiful view, but you can see you got a pretty good force carry. I mean, it's doable, but it's intimidating. And so you have to hit a nice, confident, solid drive to get across the fairway to the left side, which is the better angle. And you got bunkers in the front, and you got to cover that gorge too. And a slice can go way over here to the trees, and you're in, you got a hazard in deep trouble. From the champion tees, a little closer, the average Joe has a better chance of getting a par here. It's a shorter carry, and you can get closer up for an easier shot up to the very, very elevated green. Look at the elevation change. You have to come up from the fairway up here. I don't know if it's like a 70 foot up. There's my ball into this kind of undulating green, but it's flat in the middle. A nice smooth pitching wedge from here, and the ball's on the green to a nice birdie attempt. See how the green undulates? down and to the right into a little pit. There's a swale, a camel hump there, and then there's another tier that goes down to the back and left behind the bunkers. So, undulating hard green. I missed that 12-foot putt on the low side off the swale. It broke way more left than I thought it would. So it broke an extra couple inches and I ended up being a foot left and a little long. This one is tough. From here, you really don't need a driver because it'll go over that wall on a bounce even, and you're in real trouble. You lost the ball. And it's too hard to thread it into that area beyond the bunker between the two where the landing zone is going to be. It's really tough down there. So like a 3-iron toward the white stake is probably the idea. I could use a chop on the old driver. We'll see. A disaster for hole 8. This one, I hit a really good drive, but then I chunked the 9-iron into the bunker. The bunker shot went over the green, over that hump, and down into a bush. Had to take an unplayable. Then I chipped it over and down. It went to the right side, just at the edge of the green, and I 3-putted from there. Which is a really bad 3-putt, not that long a putt. Awful results.